And now, let's see how to perform quality controls with Ssdwlab 5. The first quality control is the percentage of positive cases, PCP. Percentage of positive cases is the most simple and one of the most useful quality controls in screening. We choose the corresponding menu and it deploys the application. We select the profile from which we obtain the percentage of positive cases and the cutoff point. We click in Compute. And automatically we obtain the mean and standard deviation of the age of the patients. The number of records that have been analyzed, the percentage of positive cases for trisomy 21. The percentage of positive cases for trisomy 18/13, and also the total screenings that are rated. We can perform the percentage of positive cases for a second trimester screening, like a double test for example. We can choose the same cutoff point or we can change it. We can observe that the mean, the standard deviation, the percentage of screenings have been analyzed, the percentage of positive cases for trisomy 21. The percentage of positive cases for trisomy 18/13, and also the percentage of positive cases of neural tube defects are calculated. We see that in total we have analyzed more than 13,000 screenings. The second quality control that we perform is the median of the multiple of the median, also called the median of moms. By gestational age in this parameter we can analyze both biochemical and echographic markers, each of them independently, as we did before. First we select the appropriate menu, and then appears the application. First we select the screening profile. In this case we choose a first trimester screening profile, then we select the marker, chorionic gonadotropin. We can see the range of dates of screening, the minimum and maximum values that adopts the marker, and type of pregnancy. We click compute. And we note that moms are calculated automatically. We see in green the value of corrected mom, and in blue the uncorrected mom. We can observe that the value of the median of multiple of the median corrected is 1, and the uncorrected is 0.98, therefore within 10% of the acceptable range. We see in the graphic at the bottom left of the screen that the median of the mom of chorionic gonadotropin is within acceptable limits at all gestational weeks in which screening is performed. At the bottom right of the screen is a summary table with the value of the corrected and uncorrected mom for different gestational weeks and the number of samples in each week. We can also calculate the value of the median mom of Papa. The value of median mom corrected is 1.02, and the uncorrected median mom value is 1. We see that it is also correct. Y is less than 10% away from value of 1. And finally for the marker nuchal translucency the value of median mom is 0.84, which is not good, and we should implement any corrective measures. The same can also be analyzed for a second trimester profile. We select the second trimester profile. Here we have two markers, alpha fetal protein and second trimester chorionic gonadotropin. We select alpha fetal protein and we press compute. The corrected median mom value is 1.02 and the uncorrected median mom value is 1.01. When we calculate the median mom for a second trimester chorionic gonadotropin, we see that the corrected median mom value is 1.01 and the uncorrected median mom value is 0.9. Let's look now the following quality control, the CUSUM. The cumulative sum of the deviations from the obtained value regarding the expected value. CUSUM is a very important quality control to the ultrasound measurements, specifically for the nuchal translucency, because it allows us to assess very reliable manner the quality with which these data are obtained from different sonographers. We select the CUSUM chart option from the main screen. Naturally, we define the profile. In this case, a first trimester screening profile. Then we select the marker, nuchal translucency. And then we execute the query. We see that the sonographer tends to underestimate the value of nuchal translucency. We can note that as the number of screenings increases, they go out of bounds. And it's regarding with what we have seen before with the value of the median MOM, which was below acceptable limits. Overestimating and underestimating are relatively common ultrasound errors when measuring the nuchal translucency. And CUSUM let us detect these errors. But we need 40 or 50 scans to detect if a sonographer is outside the range. We can calculate the CUSUM for biochemical markers. In this case, we calculate for chorionic gonadotropin. We click in compute and we see that is quite good, as they are almost all the time within proper limits. Finally, we will evaluate the screening effectiveness. To evaluate the effectiveness, it's an imperative to have perinatal outcomes, both birth and abortions that have been studied, so, first we select the menu, and appear the corresponding screen. We chose the screening profile. We define that only Gaussian makers, and only trisomy 21, were press calculate. And automatically a contingency table is presented. We can observe the number of positive cases, the number of negative cases, sensitivity, and false positive rate. We can also calculate the odds ratio and the chi-square, as the positive and negative likelihood ratio. The same can be done for a screening of the second trimester. As shown in the example in which there are many more cases, we are talking about 13,000 cases, with 40 positive cases, with 55% of detection, a false positive rate of about 7.70%. And again we can observe the odds ratio and chi-square with the respective confidence intervals. And we have calculated some quality parameters in a few steps with Ssdwlab 5 program.